had always wanted to work at NASA when I was young. I also wanted to be a waitress on roller skates and wanted to be a teacher, so it was one of my passions, but I didn't have a clear path to getting here. So when the opportunity came up, I jumped on it. I actually started college not knowing what physics was and not knowing what engineering was, quite honestly, which is funny looking back. But I decided to take a physics class on a whim. I knew it was some kind of science and I liked science. And much to my delight, I found that it was like math, but it did something. That the answers, instead of being 5, were something like 5 kilometers. So for most of my career, I've been part of a group that does laser-based measurement techniques in wind tunnels. And in the last several years, I've taken this detail assignment managing the scientifically calibrated in-flight imagery team, or SciFly, as we call ourselves. And that's been really fantastic. For me, it's exciting to be part of a team that is supporting human spaceflight and making that safer. And by getting data that allows us to quantify our different systems' performances, like parachute performance and the thermal protection system performance, we ultimately are able to help the engineers design a vehicle in a way that reduces risk and increases safety for our astronauts going back and forth to space.
Here's the portal on the left side of the aircraft where we would most likely install SAMI.
NASA is a wonderful place to work. It is a very open and inclusive and supportive place. I've had a lot of mentors who have helped me along the way. I've encountered imposter syndrome in myself in full force, and it's been very helpful to find out that I'm not unique in thinking that, because it feels like such a privilege to get to do the work that I'm doing. You know, when I look around and find myself in mission control, wearing a headset, listening to Spacecraft 1 and 2 as astronauts are talking to the people sitting next to me, it's hard to contain my inner child who's just geeking out and so excited. I had an experience where I was on travel supporting a SpaceX parachute drop test, and in the lobby there was a young girl who was wearing a NASA shirt, and being able to tell her about Artemis and how the first woman was going to be going to the moon and to hand her an Artemis pin, I saw her face light up and she ran over to her grandparents, and I heard her repeating to them, you know, do you know Artemis was Apollo's sister, and they're going to put a woman on the moon, and maybe I can go to space camp. And that was really heartening to me, to see her excitement, kind of mirroring my own excitement as a child about spaceflight and about the space shuttle program at the time.